This is Luke Paulson, the Catholic Conservative, and welcome to the News of the Week for
July 23rd, 2022.
And if you enjoy these videos, do not forget to like, comment, and most importantly, subscribe for more.
Omar and AOC handcuffed. AOC just cannot stay out of the spotlight. Since she got a taste of the acting bug by her performance accusing Alex Stein of things that did not happen, she decided to pretend to be handcuffed and arrested. Ilhan Ballot Harvesting Omar did not do much better. Just like AOC pretended that she was crying at the border, even though she was in an empty parking lot, the two socialists decided to participate in a protest in front of the Supreme Court building over the right to kill children. Everything is a performance to a professional actress. Why not drill here? Brandon went all the way to the Middle East to beg pariahs to drill for oil. Brandon has yet to say whether or not he believes that the government officials there are still pariahs, but it is safe to conclude that his handlers have not thought that part through. Rather than going to the Middle East or begging gas stations to lower their prices, there are many other simpler solutions. Not shipping oil to India or a Hunter Biden firm in China. Not shutting down a pipeline. Drilling in America and the Gulf of Mexico. Cutting regulations and taxes associated with gas and oil. Or any number of other things that have to do with limiting government authority that will never be tried. So while we peasants are struggling to pay for gas, the elites have told us to just buy Teslas. The fact that we cannot afford them is irrelevant. The fact that Newsom took time off from making ads to bring back the people he drove off, to tell them not to charge their cars for the sustainability of the grid, is also irrelevant. The fact remains that I would prefer mean tweets and lower prices to whatever Brandon is offering. Iran may have a nuke. Brandon came home from the Middle East having accomplished nothing aside from making a fool of himself. President Trump got us out of the Iran nuclear deal because he realized that they were going to build a nuclear bomb. Brandon decided that terrorist states could be trusted and got us back into the deal. Now Iran is boasting not just that they can make a nuclear bomb, but that they can make nuclear bombs. Plural! If what they are saying is true, this just means that it was foolish to get back into this deal. Once they figure this out, it is only a matter of time before we have another Cold War on our hands. Furthermore, would they share this technology with their Arab allies and create a new military threat? After Iran builds a nuke, how long before they drop it on top of Jerusalem? One more reason why President Trump was right, and the deep state had to get rid of him. Illegal alien rapes a child. What do you do if you are technically the President of the United States, and you have left the border wide open for every manner of criminal to get through, and one of them rapes a 10-year-old girl? Naturally, you need to make it all about abortion and whether or not this girl can kill her own child. I have taken the liberty of correcting Brandon's speech.
Just last week, it was reported that a 10-year-old girl was a rape victim
by an illegal alien that you helped get into the country because of your lax border policies.
10 years old.
Easily preventable by you building the wall and strengthening the border.
And she was forced to have to travel out of the state to Indiana to seek to terminate the presidency and maybe save her life. That's last part is my judgment.
Let's focus on facts, shall we? I really do not trust your judgment.
10 years old. 10 years old. Raped, 6 weeks pregnant.
Imagine if he was kept out of the country with a wall and prevented from entering with funded border patrol.
Already traumatized, was forced to travel to another state. Imagine being that little girl.
Imagine being her daughter, killed for the crime of being inconvenient.
Just imagine being that little girl, 10 years old.
Imagine being the chief law enforcement officer of this country and doing nothing to have stopped this. What happened to the girl was tragic, but her daughter did nothing wrong and was executed for the crime of being inconvenient. This is what happens with an open border. This is why President Trump was so adamant about securing the southern border. Now, did Brandon's handlers want a criminal like this inside to create a talking point? I cannot say for sure. Texas dad protects his kids. This week in the Second Amendment saves lives before government opportunists can institute civilian disarmament, I take you to Texas. We are told that there is no need for civilians to have arms because the police will protect them by the same politicians who want to defund the police. A man in Texas defended his wife and two infant children that were in his car against teen attackers. He shot both of them, and they are expected to recover. Brandon will go out of his way to mislead the American people about a rape victim, but he will never mention this. Imagine if this father had not acted. Brandon might just give a speech about how horrible it is that these two children were killed, and then demand that Congress pass more gun laws. Now that there is no option for that talking point, the Democrats have to hope that we do not mention the issue. That is why I want to mention every single one of these incidents that I come across, so that when the civilian disarmers come around again, we can be ready. However, that is not the only instance this week. Indiana man defends food court. Also this week in the Second Amendment Saves Lives, before government opportunists can institute civilian disarmament, I take you to Indiana. This time, an armed man stopped what could have been a mass shooting. You have heard the phrase. The only thing that stops a bad guy with a gun is a good guy with a gun. That is true, and it includes not only armed civilians, but funded police as well. In Indiana, a man opened fire in a food court and killed two people and wounded two more. Things could have been much worse if it had not been for what the police department called a good Samaritan with a gun. Police only arrive after the fact, but this man was on the scene already. If this good Samaritan had not been present, there would have been a mass shooting. If that had happened, the civilian disarmers would have gone crazy, passing more unconstitutional laws. However, civilian disarmers are patient and are always willing to wait until the next tragedy. But we must be ready for them. Protesting at banks. The people of China protested at their equivalent of the Federal Reserve for withholding $1.5 billion in personal accounts. Officially, the money was frozen back in April for a systems update. I seem to recall a government in North America freezing accounts based on political alignment. Either way, I would not be surprised if there was a connection between which accounts were frozen and who was a bad citizen. The protesters were told to disperse, lest they be jailed and fined. Soon after this, police came and beat the protesters. They are a totalitarian regime, and so they could order the bank to unfreeze the money. But something tells me that the suits in Beijing are handing down orders. As I said, funds were frozen in Canada. How long before this happens right here in America? It is not a matter of if, just a matter of when. Democrats love Mammon. The Brandon administration, like most socialists, is not a fan of religion. Karl Marx wanted to get rid of religion, calling it the opiate of the masses.
If someone owes their allegiance to anyone other than the government, that person will not see government as the highest power. People like this believe that for the good of all, the state is the highest good. I introduce you to the succinctly named DRL-FY20-IRF, promoting and defending religious freedom inclusive of atheist, humanist, non-practicing, and non-affiliated individuals. Basically giving government grants to atheists. They already get plenty of money coming into the education system to promote godless evolution and rewriting of history. What more do they want? This is just step one. More atheist propaganda from this and the next Democrat administration will come along. Again, not a matter of if, just a matter of when. No evidence of whips. Imagine taking an incredibly happenstance photo that makes it look like migrants are being whipped by Border Patrol. Imagine telling people that the photo is not what it appears, and people still attacking said Border Patrol agents. It has come out that Border Patrol never whipped anyone. Just like Kyle Rittenhouse or Nick Sandman, the people who made those false accusations need to be sued for everything that they are worth. Although in truth, nothing will happen, because these people do not care about the truth. They just care about a political narrative. This was not about human rights. This was all about handicapping Border Patrol to let more illegals in. If the Democrats can get enough illegals in, they can shift the demographics. After all, they want people who will vote for them to get free stuff. Definitions change. Again. Online dictionaries such as Merriam-Webster have bowed to the woke crowd and rewritten the definition of the word woman. Instead of referring to an adult human female, now one definition is that one is not male. They will probably change the definition of man to mean one that is not female. That is like defining a mountain as a large hill and a hill as a large mountain. This was coming bit by bit. People like Alex Jones and Mark Dice tried to warn us that this was going to happen, but they were written off as conspiracy theorists. Now anyone who disagrees with Newspeak is called a hateful bigot. This is not going to stop anytime soon. I cannot speak for anyone else, but I will continue to speak up until I am thrown into a gulag or martyred. Women impregnated without men. Maybe I'm just blowing smoke. Maybe I'm completely off my rocker, but that is just my opinion. And if you enjoyed this content, do not forget to like, comment, and most importantly, subscribe for more. And also don't forget to follow me on social media.